Hello everyone, welcome to my channel, myself Arpita Paul, and in my today's tutorial I will tell you how to perform linear searching in Java using one dimensional array. So let's start the video. For that we have a simple program here to accept 5 elements in an array and accept another number from the user and check whether it is present in the array or not. If it is present, then print the position where it is found using linear search method. So basically we will input 5 elements in the array and we will accept another number from the user. Then we will check if the number is present in the array or not. If it is present, then we will print the position where it is found. Okay, and we will use the linear search method here. So let's start the writing part. For that, first we will write import space java.util.asterisk. We will use this util package because we will use scanner class to take input. So for that we have to import util package here. After that we will write our class, then within the class we will write our main method. Okay, then within the main method, in first line we will create the scanner class object by writing scanner space sc equals to new space scanner system.in. Then after that, in the next line we will declare the array and we will initialize the size of the array by writing int space arr third brackets equals to new space int within third bracket 5. So here arr is the array name and it will hold integer type values because the data type is int, and it will store maximum 5 elements. Okay, so let me show you how it will look like in the memory. This is how it will look like in the memory. Arr is the name of the array, 5 memories will be allocated and all the memory will be initialized with value 0. Okay, so in the next line we are printing system.out.println, enter the number for checking. So here we will enter the number which we want to check. So for that we are declaring a variable named n, which is also integer type, and we are using the next in scanner class method to take input. Okay, so here we will input the value of n or enter the number and we will store it within n. So say the number is 5. Okay, now we are printing system.out.println, enter all the elements. So now we will enter elements of the array. For that we are using the for loop. Okay, and the for loop is starting from index 0 and it will continue up to index 4, and we are using same next in scanner class method to take input and store it within array. Okay, so this is how it will look like after taking input. See, all the values will be entered as per the respective index values. Okay, if you don't know how to take the input or how the for loop works, please go through my previous videos where I have explained all this, and the video links are provided in the description box. Okay, now this is how it will look like. Okay, now we will check the number is present in the array or not. For that we are writing the same for loop here again. So we are writing for int I equals to 0, I less than 5, I plus plus. So the index value of array will start from 0 and it will continue up to 4. Okay, that is why we have written I less than 5. So now initially the value of I is 0. Okay, so it 0 less than 5, yes, so it will get inside. Now it will check, we will write the if statement n equals to arr of I. So value of n is 5 and value of I is 0. So the initial checking will be done against this 0th index. So value of n is 5 and 0th index have the value 10. Okay, so it has the value 10. So it will check here 5 equals to 10. No, it is not satisfying, so it will not get inside the if statement. Then it will directly go to the increment part and it will increment the value of I. So now the value of I will be 1. Okay, now 1 less than 5, yes, it will get inside. Now it will check the value of n with the value present in the index 1. Okay, so now it will check 5 equals to 5, because value of n is 5 and index 1 is having the value 5. So 5 equals to 5. Yes, it is satisfying. So now it will get inside the loop and it will print number found at the position and the position. So here it will print number found at the position 1 plus 1 equals to 2. Why this? See, what is the current value of I? 1. And we are writing I plus 1 to print the position. Why? Because the index of the array always starts from 0. And in real life, there is no position named 0th position. So actually, the 0 index is holding the first position. So whatever the index value the element is having, it will be present in the next position. That means the position of the value will be index value plus 1. That means the 5 is present in the second position. That is why we are doing I plus 1 to print the position. Okay. So here it is found at index 1. So the value of the I is 1. So 1 plus 1 becomes 2. So the first element 5 is found at the position 2. Okay. So after that, again the value of I will be incremented and it will be 2. And 2 less than 5, yes. So it will get inside and next value will be checked against second index. So now it will check 5 equals to 20. No, it is not satisfying. So it will not get inside the if statement. So it will directly go to the increment part of the I. So now the value of I will be 3. So 3 less than 5, yes, it will get inside. Now the next checking will be done against the index value of 3. So now index 3 has value 5. So again it will check 5 equals to 5. Yes, it is present. So now it will get inside the if statement and it will print the value number found at the position I plus 1. So the current value of I is 3 and plus 1 equals to 4th position. So you can see 1st, 2nd, 3rd, 4th. So this 5 is present in the 4th position. Okay. Now after doing this, it will go to the increment part and the value of I will be 4 now. So 4 less than 5, yes, it will get inside. So the next element will be checked against the 4th index value. So 5 equals to 30. No, it is not satisfying. So it will not get inside the if statement. It will again go to the increment part and the value of I will be 5. So 5 less than 5, it is not satisfying. So it will come out of the for loop. Okay. So you can see here, if we are entering the same value twice or thrice, means more than one times, then it will print all the positions where the number is present. Okay. So if the number which we are checking is coming in the array repeatedly, then also it will print all the position. Okay. So let me show you the output, how it will look like. So I am compiling the program. Class compiled, no syntax error. Now right click on the class, click on void main, click on OK. Now you can see enter the number for checking. So I am entering 5. 5 is the number which we will check. Now enter all elements. So I am entering same values 10, 5, 20, 5 and 30. Okay. So you can see the output here, number found at the position 2, number found at the position 4. You can see we have entered 5 and 5 is present in position 2, 5 is present in position 4 also. So this is how easily we can take input in the array and we can take input some other number and we can check if the number is present in the array or not. Okay. So this method is called linear search method. So thank you everyone. Like and share the video and don't forget to subscribe to my channel for more videos. Thank you.